Hi Taterheads, I'm Josh.
And I'm RJ.
And we're the Couch Potatoes, and today we're reviewing Dread 3D.
Feel as if time is passing at 1% its normal speed.
If we play this right, we could take the whole city.
Awesome. Okay, everybody. So, Dread. A decent film idea, you know, they're remaking Judge Dredd, kind of, plus it's based off a really exciting graphic novel. Sadly, this graphic novel had a short, limited release, but I think, nonetheless, it's a cool idea to make it. Sylvester Stallone did okay, Rob Schneider was the standout, which shows how good this film was. But, Dredd. Josh?
I wasn't really a big fan of the movie, and I wasn't really a big fan of the graphic novel. I was a fan, though, of the concept. I really liked the concept, and I hoped that in both versions that they went a lot deeper. But with this film, I finally got that.
Exactly. Now, story-wise, what happens in Dredd? Basically, two officers, one being Judge Dredd himself and a rookie, get a call about a triple homicide in a giant 200-story building. And they find out this drug they've been looking for, which is a basically a slow-mo drug that you take from an inhaler, is being run by the mob boss herself, Mama, from Game of Thrones.
Play this right, we can take the whole city.
Mama's controlling all the slow-mo production and distribution.
Rookie, you ready?
Very good actress, I must say, by the way.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of Game of Thrones, and I was really excited to see her in this. I actually didn't know that she was in it until, like, a few weeks ago, which really got me pumped for the movie. Though, I will say this, I was not hyped for this movie. I went in with very low expectations. Just because, for one thing, the source material isn't that good. Especially since they said, oh, this is a remake of the original Dredd movie. Which, it turned out, it's not. It's like saying Prometheus is a prequel to Aliens.
Yes, but more importantly, we gotta get to the acting. Because this had some pretty fun acting, in my opinion.
Yeah.
The woman who played Mama... Ashley had a very sadistic, bloody feel, which I love. The scar on her face looked beautiful. Carl Urban, an actor I personally don't know too well, played Dredd as the one-hit wonder I freaking have always wanted Dredd to be. Which, by that I mean, he said every one-liner so perfect, I could not stop laughing. It was that funny.
This law's gotta break some of the same rules as the rest of the city. Mama's not the law. I am the law.
Seriously, though, every line of his was a one-liner, and for me, that was a little distracting. Just, it was a bit much. Like, it felt a little over the top at times.
I am the law. 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 I am the The saving factor for this movie is Mama. She's the lady who plays her. I'm a huge fan of her. I can't remember her name right now, but I'm a huge fan of her on Game of Thrones, and I've seen some other movies that she's in. She usually plays this, like, sweet person and really beautiful actress. This and Game of Thrones were really her branching out, and she's become huge because of that. I think this is a really good role for her. I'm not saying, like, award material here, obviously, but she did a really good performance, and she's really the saving factor of this movie for me.
Plus, let's not forget about the lead actress, alongside with Carl Urban. I cannot remember her name either, but you know what? She actually shined really well for me in this movie. She had a psychic ability, something that to a lot of people would think would hinder the film, but it made it better. It worked so well. They used it to comedic advantages and creepy advantages. Like, there's a few scenes in there where even I was like, oh my god.
Yeah, as soon as I did not know that she was going to be a psychic going into the movie. As soon as they announced, oh, she has psychic abilities, I'm like, are you... No.
Facepalm.
No. Why? Like, when it was announced, I just literally asked myself, why is this happening? Why do they need a psychic in here? But again, like I said at the beginning of the video, I was proven wrong. Like, they worked it so well, integrating it with the rest of the story. I was flabbergasted. I honestly didn't know what to say.
And let's not forget about direction. The direction of this film was very well done. Whether it was the filming, which was unbelievable, especially the fact that it made you feel like you were in a 200-story building. Freaking insane. And, I mean, okay, the effects. This is the big thing we gotta talk about. The effects were stunning. Whether it was gunfire, blood, the slow-mo, which was beautiful, the sounds, even, like, it was all, like, just a mystified sound experience with beauty.
Yeah. The thing is, last year, there's a movie that came out, and I do have to bring this up, The Raid. It's the same exact concept of people just going up a building, killing a bunch of people to reach the top to get the bad guy. But with the direction and the editing and effects in this movie, this makes it enough, like, different to be its own movie. And I, watching it, I totally forgot about The Raid, and I wasn't like, that was in The Raid, that was in The Raid, that was in The Raid. I was like, I'm watching Dread right now, killing a bunch of people, shooting someone through the cheek.
Exactly. Now, overall, this film overall to me was just fun, exciting, and a gore fest, which I was expecting this film to be. I laughed, I even got creeped out in a few scenes. Now, we have what we call the spud-o-meter. We haven't had this in a while. How many spuds we give this film from 0 to 5? Personally, for me, I'm gonna give this film 4 spuds. It was exciting, it was thrilling, and it kept me guessing to the end. Josh?
Yeah, really, my thoughts about the movie, I know I've said it a few times before, but going in, I was not looking forward to it. But it met my expectations and surpassed it tremendously. But I will say this, it's not that great of a movie. It is a good movie. Like, I would definitely say go and rent it or see it in theaters. But if you do see it in theaters, see it in 3D. It is actually worth seeing it in 3D. So I guess my spud count would be... I'll give it a 3.5. I can't go a full 4 just because I didn't, like, love the movie, but...
That's way more than I expected you to give, Josh. Now, everybody, thank you. That was our review of Judge Dredd. We thank you very much for watching our videos. Keep checking them out, and please subscribe. We are the Caps Potatoes, and may the spud be with you.
Spud out.